Welcome back. And if you tuned in late, we are talking about good health and the way you can restore yourself. And I have from the Hallelujah Diet, I have two special people here, Paul and Ann Malkmus. And now you're going to do this salad. Mm-hmm. And it's called a broccoli pea salad. Now, none of this is cooked.
No.
Okay.
No. Do you remember years ago when we had the pea salad and it was filled with cheese and it was filled with peas?
Yeah.
And we're taking that and we're going to change it to make it a lot more healthier.
All right.
So we started out by creating just little florets of the broccoli, and we cut them up into small little florets. In addition to that, we added some small little florets of the cauliflower.
Oh.
Very healthy already, because these two are very important for people that are fighting cancer. One of the best things you can do to fight cancer is eat this every day. Another thing we did is we added some celery. High in natural sodium, just excellent for you. The other thing we did, and it's something we just decided to add for color, we cut up some small amounts of red pepper.
I love red peppers.
And it just adds such a beautiful color to that. And finally, we added a little bit of red onion, another very strong anti-cancer. Don't need a lot if you don't like it, but it's really quite easy.
And that's a hefty salad. That would serve
a
certainly
number.
A family.
Yes, ma'am.
Know.
And on top of that, we're going to add some frozen sweet peas.
Okay.
And we don't need to add a lot, just some. And from this, you're going to have the most beautiful salad. And we use a special kind of mayonnaise. It's made out of grapeseed oil. And it's called Veginaise.
Okay.
So we add that in there. And of course, I measure this perfectly.
But Anne, if somebody didn't have that and they wanted to try, they could use the traditional and it
yes,
would be okay.
Yes, absolutely. Look at all the vegetables they're putting in that traditional mayonnaise. That's exactly right.
Oh, that's beautiful. It's colorful.
In addition to that, I'm going to spread a little bit of dill, because the dill adds the flavor. And you already saw how pretty the color is. And so what we'll do is we'll be mixing this. And of course, I mixed it in a much smaller bowl than I should have. Always. We got so excited when we cut up all these
this
vegetables.
This would serve quite a few people.
Yes, it will. It absolutely will. And you always mix it in a different bowl than the one that you serve it in. When you're completing all of this, then you put this in a much cleaner bowl, because it makes it much more attractive. It doesn't have all the mixing marks on the bottom.
Okay.
And that's the key to making sure that people look at your beautiful food and they say, oh, how pretty. Put it in pretty bowls because
it's pretty.
So
really, the only thing difficult about this was the time to chop it up.
Yeah, and it didn't take us long at all.
This would be great to take to a church supper or any place you need, picnic, whatever.
That's right. And if you want to, you can put it on a bed of leafy greens. It's entirely up to you.
And of course, if you're traditional, this would go very well with fish,
yes,
or chicken, or anything.
Absolutely. That's exactly right. So after you've completed
Anne, that's pretty.
Isn't that a beautiful color?
Oh, yes.
And these are vegetables you can get all year long. You can get broccoli
now,
and cauliflower.
Now, what are the nuts you put?
You would just sprinkle this on the top, just like that.
Yes.
And that is the garnishing of this beautiful salad.
Okay, so you just have the slivered almonds on
that's
top.
All. That's right.
That's
and that's
beautiful.
Your salad. Isn't that pretty?
It certainly is.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one way you can get your kids involved in eating some veggies.
Pretty quickly, too.
Yeah. Now, you've got this chocolate pudding.
We
do. We don't want to run out of time
before
the chocolate pudding.
Yes, ma'am.
While they're getting that ready, you know, let me just say, these recipes are yours free for the asking. We do appreciate that self-addressed stamped envelope if you can. Or you can click on peggydenny.com and we'll post it for you. And just ask for recipe number 848 and send it to the Peggy Denny Show, Post Office Box 1616, Greenville, South Carolina, 29602. And these are things you can try. They're good, you know, they're good, but they're also good for you. And we encourage people, if you want to learn more, this is like a magazine, and it's free. And you can call the 800 number, and you can have one of those, and it will introduce you to some of the wonderful things that boost your health. And it doesn't matter if you're a senior citizen or a school child. We all need to know how to take care of ourselves. Now, you've got avocados.
Have you ever eaten avocados before?
Did I what?
Have you ever eaten avocados
before? Oh, I love them.
Oh, we love them, too.
Oh, yes.
They're one of our favorites. When we do this recipe, though, it's amazing how many people have never tried avocados.
Or they don't like them. Mm-hmm. They're afraid to try them because they're green.
Oh, I love avocados. In salad, yeah.
So
how many do you have there?
We have four.
And this is going to be a chocolate pudding?
Yes.
Are you confused? Chocolate pudding with avocado.
There really are only three ingredients in this recipe.
We just don't want to run out of time until you get this in here.
We're moving fast.
What? Three?
We're going to use three avocados in this.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And we have two other ingredients, and that's all. The only other two ingredients we're going to add is we're adding 3/4 cup of pure maple syrup. Pure maple syrup.
Ooh.
And if you don't have cocoa powder, some people use cocoa powder. It's easy to find. We use something called carob powder because carob powder doesn't have any caffeine. That's it. That's what makes chocolate pudding. No dairy.
And then you just put it in the blender.
And then that's it. And then you make a beautiful chocolate pudding out of that.
And it really tastes like chocolate.
I'm hoping you're going to find out real soon.
Well, live and learn.
Okay.
Okay.
Now. Let's see what that looks like.
So this, you would serve this as a dessert, obviously.
Yes, in fact, this is a beautiful beginning to a chocolate peanut butter pie that we make almost every time we have guests. See, we love to eat, and we make wonderful food. It just doesn't have to have bad food in it.
The salad is just, where is the salad? Let me put this salad down here where people can see it. And then there are some bars that are good for you. If you're rushed and you don't have time to have a really good, you'll get a nutrition.
We call those survival bars.
Survival bars, okay.
See how thick and rich this chocolate pudding is?
That's amazing.
It's beautiful. And all that's in there are three ingredients.
And then you've got your maple syrup, which gives it...
Sweet.
Sweet. So it is a dessert.
Yes, ma'am.
But it's all raw.
Yes. Yeah, it's a living food.
No refined sugar.
No dairy. Mm-hmm. How pretty is that?
So if people would slowly incorporate some of this into their lifestyle and perhaps get out there and take a little walk.
Yes.
And if you smoke, put down the cigarettes, you could change your whole life.
Yes.
Step
by step.
This is beautiful.
Now, you need to take a taste of that.
We're hoping
you
will.
If I take a taste, then I will. Oh, my goodness.
It's like chocolate.
It's delicious.
It's like chocolate pudding.
I'll put this down. Look, I'll put it out here where people can see it.
It's amazing how delicious fresh vegetables and fruits
are. It really
is.
Mm-hmm. I'm amazed. And you do all kinds of foods for...
We make cheesecakes. We make some extraordinary fettuccine Alfredo. We make all of this without dairy and without cheese.
And your book, which we didn't have to show, but your book is available through the 800 number, and it's a wonderful book. I've looked at it.
A lot of research went into that book. It's a good book. People will really appreciate learning a lot.
Okay, now, so, Paul, what do you want to add to this before we're out of time about the Hallelujah Diet?
Right, well, we mentioned, you know, sometimes it's hard to know where to get started. And Ann and I did a program called 60 Days to Reclaim Your Health. And every day somebody gets a video and they see how to do this at home. It's a free program and they can go to 60daystoreclaimyourhealth.com and sign up for free.
This was done in our home. So you got to see our kitchen. You got to see us do all sorts of different activities, and they're not fancy. They help people make a decision on how to change their life.
Or they could even call that 800 number and say that they wanted the 60-day...
To reclaim your health.
To reclaim your health program.
And they'll help them get signed on online. Mm-hmm.
Do you feel that Americans are in danger? Our diets are so bad, and fast food places, that we are endangering our health?
Oh, without a doubt. And the only person who can make a difference in that is the individual themselves. So, you know, it can be changed. We, you know, Ann was talking about her fibromyalgia and her IBS. And within a year, her IBS and her fibromyalgia were gone. Her daughter, who had rheumatoid arthritis, gone within a year. Yeah. And now she's 27 years old.
Yeah.
So we can do things to help ourselves. Mm-hmm. And you can do it gradually.
Right.
I mean, you don't have to just... People are afraid to make drastic changes, but you can do little things at a time like this.
Yes. In the program that we have, we didn't tell them to take anything out of their diet the first several days. We just started putting good things into the diet.
That's all.
And you and I can learn. We're never too late to learn how to do better and be better. And this is really very informative. Mm-hmm. And I thank you for your willingness to share with other people. And I'll keep the information here if you didn't get it. But this is Recipe 848. We'll be glad to share them with you. Bless you for what you're doing.
Well,
thank you. Will you come back?
If you'd like us to.
Oh, we'd love to. Thank you so much. And wherever you are, eat healthy. And we'll see you next time.